first law for non-flow process. As we know, non-flow process is nothing but a closed system, right? So for a non-flow process, what is meant by closed system? Only heat interactions are takes place, but no work interaction. Agree? Yes or no? In closed system, only heat interactions are possible, no mass interaction. Okay, right. Basically, we have five different types of process. Actually, strictly speaking, four only. Five is the generalized equation. This is the generalized equation for all process. Generalized equation. Okay, so as we already discussed some basics of processes, when the system is changing its state, let us take a PV diagram. PV diagram, and let us say this is the piston cylinder, and the piston is at the outer dead center. Inside the system piston, we have some gas. Gas is there, right? So let us say the state is one. Its initial state is one. The pressure is P1 and volume is V1, right? So when the piston is at the outer dead center, it has occupied full volume but less pressure. Let us say this corresponding to state one. Now, what I am doing, I am applying force or pressure over the piston so that the gas inside the system will be compressed. Now, let us assume this is the final state of the piston, and now the gas inside this one will be compressed, and that state will be state two. Now, what happens to pressure? Pressure is increased and volume is decreased. So let us say this is the state 2. Okay, already discussed, state is nothing but unique condition of a system. Each unique condition of a system is called state, and this is state 1, state 2. When the system is changing its state from one state to other state, when the system is changing from one state to other state, it will follow certain thing. This is called path, and this path depends upon the process it follows. The path, the system depends upon the process it follows. When the system is, try to understand this concept, when the system is changing its state from one state to other state, it has to follow any of these four processes. When the system is changing its state from one state to other state, it has to follow any of these four processes. Those processes may be constant volume process or constant pressure process, constant temperature, and constant entropy. These are the four processes the system has to follow when it is changing its state. Agree? Yes or no? Okay, right. Constant volume process is also known as isochoric process. Core is nothing but volume. Right? So, anyone having idea of Super Splendor bike?
Super Splendor. Splendor, acha.
Yeah, I think it's 10 years back or 15 years back I'm talking about. The one ad came in TVs.
Oh, sir.
Right? So, the ad is the quantum core engine for Super Splendor. You can search in the net. So, they will specify that quantum core engine. Right? So the core is nothing but the volume. The core is nothing but the volume, right? So like that you can remember easily. Constant volume process is also known as isochoric process. And constant pressure, the unit of the pressure is bar. So you can remember it is isobaric process. The way I am explaining, right? How to remember the different types of process. In some problems, instead of giving it follows constant volume, you may give like it follows isochoric process.
You should know.
That's what. If he specifies isochoric process, you are in a position to understand that it comes under constant volume. Because if you get confused between isochoric and isobaric, then it will be difficult to solve the problem. Though you solve the problem, you will get wrong answer. Okay, core is nothing but volume, bar is nothing but pressure. Okay, right. And constant temperature process, we can say it is isothermal. You can easily remember. Isothermal is nothing but constant temperature process. And constant entropy process is called as adiabatic process. adiabatic. Adiabatic means no heat interaction. Q is equals to zero. When there is no heat interaction, then the entropy is constant, right? So if the process is reversible adiabatic, then it is also called as isentropic. Isentropic, you can see entropy. Isentropic means entropy is constant, right? So these are the four different processes we have, and this is generalized process, and I'll explain with help of one screen, right? So what is the equation of state? PV is equal to R into T. I'll change the color to white. PV equal to R into T, where P is the pressure. V is what?
Wall.
It's not one.
Specific volume.
Specific volume is volume per mass. What is R?
Gas constant.
It is nothing but R naught by
P naught.
M. For now. Here R naught is the universal gas constant. It is universal gas constant. And M is the molar or molecular mass. Molar or molecular mass. And T is the absolute temperature. Equals to absolute temperature. Clear? Is the writing is clear?
Yes.
Now, so here, understandable, right?
Yes, sir.
P equal to RT. This is the equation of the state. Okay, equation of state. Now, first process, let us say what we discussed, constant volume. For constant volume process, if volume is constant, then it gives rise to P is proportional to RT. Agree? This equation can be written like this. If volume is constant, specific volume is also constant. So therefore, P is proportional to R into T. R is also, let us say, for a particular gas, R is also a constant. Therefore, this equation gives rise to P by T is equals to constant. This is the governing equation for constant volume process. Clear? Clear or not?
Yes, sir.
Particular process, if the volume is constant, therefore I can write P by T is equals to constant. Nothing but P1 by T1 is equals to P2 by T2. From state 1 to state 2, I can apply like this. For constant volume process. Okay. Now, coming to the constant pressure process. Constant pressure. This is constant volume is isochoric process. And constant pressure is isobaric process. Isobaric process. So, for isobaric process, which is constant? P is equals to constant. Here, from constant volume, V is equals to constant. So, V is equals to constant, right? In this equation, PV is equals to RT. Once P is equals to constant, therefore I can write V is proportional to RT. Anyhow, R is also a constant. From this, I can write V is proportional to T. Nothing but V by T is equals to constant. That is equal to V1 by T1 is equals to V2 by T2. Clear? For isobaric process, the governing equation is V by T is equal to constant. For isobaric process. P by T is equals to constant for constant volume or isochoric process. Third process, we have constant temperature process. As the other name, we know it is isothermal process. Okay. And for isothermal process, T is equals to constant. When T is equals to constant, from equation of state, I can write PV is proportional to R. Anyhow, R is also constant. PV is equals to constant. So this is the governing equation for isothermal process. PV is equals to constant. For state 1 to 2, I can write P1 V1 is equals to P2 V2. For in from state 1 to state 2, I can write P1 V1 is equals to P2 V2. This is the constant temperature or isothermal process. And finally, we have adiabatic process. Adiabatic is also called as isentropic. Adiabatic is also called as isentropic process. In this case, entropy is equals to constant. S is equals to constant. The governing equation is PV power gamma is equals to constant. You remember simply, PV power gamma equal to constant, where gamma is called as adiabatic index. Where gamma is called as adiabatic index. Adiabatic
sir, index. Yeah. Gamma is whole PV or only V?
Sorry?
Gamma is for whole PV or only V, sir? Gamma is whole whole power or only it is for V?
Only for V. P V power gamma. Not PV power gamma. P V power gamma. Okay? For two states, I can say P1 V1 power gamma is equals to P2 V2 power gamma. For your understanding sake, I can write V1 by V2 whole power gamma is equals to P2 by P1. Now it is clear? Or if you want to write volume ratio, V1 by V2 can be written as P2 by P1 whole power 1 by gamma. Clear? These four processes means I want governing equations for all these four processes. Okay, na?
Clear.
Right, right. One second. Right. So I said for constant volume process, P by T is equals to constant. For constant pressure process, V by T is equals to constant. For isothermal process, PV is equals to constant. For adiabatic process, PV power gamma is equals to constant. Yes or no? So this is for constant volume, and this is for constant pressure, and this is for constant temperature, and this is for constant entropy. Yes or no? These are the four processes. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. And I said PV power N is equals to constant. That is a generalized equation. PV power N. Is this color is visible? Green color? Is this green color is visible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Usually this is called polytropic process. PV power N is called polytropic. Polytropic process. And we can also call it as generalized equation. Means by changing the N value, by changing the N value, we will get the different types of process. Okay. So N by varying the N. Suppose if N is equals to 0. If N is equals to 0, which implies what you will get? In this equation, if you put N value equal to 0, what you will get?
P is constant.
P equal to constant. Okay. Suppose if N is equals to 1, what you will get? If N equal to 1, what you will get? Please respond.
PV equal to constant.
PV equal to constant. If N is equals to infinite, what you will get? If n equal to infinite, what you will get? V is equals to constant. And if n is equals to gamma, we will get as PV power gamma is equals to constant. Clear? So that is the reason I can call polytropic process as generalized equation. Just by changing the value of n, we will get the different types of process. When n equal to 0, it is constant pressure process. When n equal to 1, it is the constant temperature process. When n equal to infinite, it is constant volume. When n equal to gamma, it is adiabatic or isentropic process. Okay, shall I move to slide? If it is clear, then I'll go to the slide.
Sir, at gamma, how V is constant?
It's not gamma. N is equals to infinite. N is equals to power infinite. Is equals to constant.
How, sir?
Yeah, right. So infinite I can written as? Infinite I can written as? Infinite is equals to 1 by 0.
Yes, sir.
PV power 1 by 0 is equals to constant. Okay. V power 1 by 0 is equals to some constant by P. And V is equals to constant by P whole power 0. Clear?
Yes, sir. Clear.
Right, na? Anything power 0 equal to 1. Okay? Right. Right. So these are the four different types of processes. Okay. So just now I explained how to write V P by T equal to constant. Okay. And V by T equal to constant and PV equal to constant and PV power gamma equal to constant. You should not have any doubt in this one. Whenever I ask P by T equal to constant, which type of process means you should say it is isochoric or constant volume process. Whenever it is V by T equal to constant means it is a constant pressure or isobaric process. Clear, na? If it is clear, I'll discuss one by one. In all these four processes, we are going to discuss what is work interaction and what is the heat interaction for all these four processes. We are going to discuss heat and work interactions for all the four processes. One by one, we'll discuss. Are you comfortable with the terminology? If S, tell me, I'll discuss constant volume process today.
Yes, sir.
Terminology is clear. Then I'll go to constant volume process. Okay. Okay, right. Now, before going to constant volume process, first let me explain how to represent these different types of process in PV diagram. Okay. For easily understanding sake, what I did, I used same color for both PV and TS diagram. Okay. Okay. Now, what we will do? We will start with one processes. First, what is the first process we have? Constant volume process. So, as we know, for constant volume process, so in PV diagram, what is the line? How to represent constant volume line in PV diagram? I already explained. How to represent process for constant volume in PV diagram? It is vertical line. Agree?
Agreed, sir.
Right. We can see here. This is P. This is V. So if it is a vertical line, then only state 1, 2, 2. V1 is equals to V2. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Right. Now we can see here in PV diagram, this represents, this line represents state 1, let us say this is state 2. Now this green color indicates it is a constant volume process. Agree? Right. And at the same time, when you will get constant volume process in PV power n equal to constant, when n value is equals to infinite. Agree? Just now I proved it. When n is equals to infinite, it indicates that V is equals to constant. Right? So this green color line represents constant volume process, right? And in the same way, in TS diagram, if you see in TS diagram, this green color line is represented by a curve. Yes or no?
Yes,
this
sir.
Is state 1, this is state 2. So okay. 1, 2, 2, what happens to temperature? 1, 2, 2, what happens to temperature?
1, 2, 2. Constant, sir.
Temperature, I am talking about constant volume process. You can see this green color line.
Yes, sir.
Constant, V1 is equals to V2.
Mm.
V1 is equals to V2.
Mm.
Then for this state 1, 2, 2, what happens to the temperature, I am asking? Temperature is increasing, agree?
Yes, sir. Temperature is increasing.
Yeah, whether it is increasing or decreasing, we don't bother. Our main intention is how to represent constant volume line in PV and TS diagram. Okay. In PV diagram, constant volume line is represented by a vertical line, and in TS diagram, it is represented by a curve. That is my motto of this slide. Is it is clear how to represent constant volume line in PV and TS diagram? Very, very, very important. If you know how to represent the process on PV and TS diagram, then only you can solve the problem. Otherwise, it is very difficult to solve the problem. As we know, the area under PV diagram gives the work done, and the area under TS diagram gives the heat flow. Because in order to calculate the work done, you should know how to represent the process on PV diagram. That is the reason I am discussing.
Okay, sir.
Yeah, please mute your mics. Right. Now, you are clear about constant volume process for PV and TS diagram. If anyone is having doubt, please ask me. How to represent PV diagram and TS diagram for constant volume process? Clear, na? Constant volume. Now.
Sir, in PV diagram, clear, sir. But TS diagram, it's not clear.
In TS diagram, it is a curve. Remember like that. In TS diagram, the constant volume is represented. Let us say this is the TS diagram. TS, it represents the constant volume. That's it. Okay? Now.
Yes, sir.
Right. Now, second case we'll discuss constant pressure process. For constant pressure process for PV diagram, because in TS diagram, we don't have volume. You can see only temperature entropy we can express in TS diagram. Agree? In PV diagram, we can express only volume and pressure. Okay? Right. Now, so constant pressure process for PV diagram, it is a horizontal line. Agree? Let us assume this is state 1, this is state 2. 1, 2, 2, you can say P1 is equals to P2, pressure is constant. So which line we are showing for constant pressure? This orange color, let us say, light yellow. Now, you can see here, for constant pressure for TS diagram, this is state 1, this is state 2. There is no much difference between constant volume and constant pressure line in TS diagram, only the slope is going to vary. Agree? Both constant pressure and constant volume lines in TS diagram are curve only. Only the difference is the inclination. The inclination is different. Which is having more slope, constant volume or constant pressure? Which curve is having more slope?
Constant volume.
Constant volume is more steeper compared to the constant pressure. That is the only difference. Otherwise, both are curves only. Because I can't represent pressure or volume in TS diagram. I can't represent volume or pressure in TS diagram, those things will become curve. In the same way, I can't represent temperature and entropy in PV diagram. In PV diagram, I can represent only pressure and volume. So therefore, the other two, temperature and entropy, will become curve here. Here, these two, temperature and entropy, will become straight line. You find the difference?
Yes, sir.
Right? So whenever it is possible to represent, then they will get lines. If the parameter is not there in the coordinates, then that will become curve. Blindly can remember. As we can see, for in PV diagram, I can represent pressure and volume. That's why pressure, constant pressure and constant volume, both are represented by straight line. And in TS diagram, I can't represent pressure or volume. That's why those two are indicated by curve.
Curve.
Right. Now, third process is constant temperature process. Now, constant temperature process, I will start with TS diagram. okay, because I can represent temperature directly in TS diagram.
Okay, sir.
Right. So now we can see constant temperature line will be, it is denoted with red color, where, yes, right? So state 1, state 2. Now you can write T1 is equals to
T2.
Because it is a horizontal line.
Yes, where
in PV diagram, I can't represent temperature. That's why it is a curve. We can see this is the T is constant. Constant temperature or isothermal process. State 1 to 2. Let us say state 1 and this is state 2. So red colored one in PV diagram denotes isothermal process. Okay. The only thing is in PV diagram, they are moving downward direction. And in TS diagram, they are sloping upward direction. Here the slope is in downward direction. Here the slope is in upward direction. Okay. Okay. Right. Again, next one, what is the other process we have? Isentropic process. Isentropic process is entropy is equals to constant. When entropy is constant, then we can call it as isentropic process. Let us assume this is state 1 and undergoing 1, 2, 2. Then I can write S1 is equals to S2. I can
represent,
I can represent entropy in TS diagram. Therefore, it is a straight line, that too vertical line. It is denoted with color, pink color, let us say.
Yes, okay. Sir.
So you can see pink color in PV diagram. It is the isentropic or adiabatic process, PV power gamma. PV power gamma. Again, in PV diagram, isothermal and isentropic processes are similar. Only.
Yes, sir.
Only thing is, isentropic process is more steeper compared to the isothermal
process.
Right, sir. Right, no? Right. Very important diagram. Please make a note of this figure. Just I'll give 1 or 2 minutes time. Very, very important thing. Just make a note. Very, very important. If you are able to draw the figures, means the processes, then only we can solve problems. Okay? Right. Make a note. Make a note of this figure. Or you can take a screenshot.
Yes, sir. 1 minute.
And we can see in between isothermal process and adiabatic process. What happened? Came again. Right, in between isothermal process, okay, and adiabatic process, there is a blue dotted line. Can you see?
Yes, sir.
Dotted line, that process is called polytropic process, and the governing equation for polytropic process is PV power N. No, it is a polytropic process. It is PV power N is equals to constant, where N is a variable, In the value of N, we will get the different types of processes. As we know, N is equals to 0 means it is a constant pressure process. N is equals to 0. And N is equals to 1 equals to 1 means it is a isothermal process. N is equals to infinite, constant volume process. N is equals to, it is a adiabatic process. That is the reason polytropic process is the generalized equation. You can see polytropic process is in between isothermal and adiabatic.
Yes, sir.
Adiabatic
process is in between isothermal and adiabatic. In PV diagram, we have, let us assume adiabatic, polytropic, isothermal. Okay. Now you can see from here to here, let us say this is state 1, close and I'll open so that these marks will not show, come and discard. Can you see the screen now?
Yes, sir.
Right. I'll explain in it now. So here, here state 1, let us assume 1, 1, in between here 2, 3, 3, Now I am explaining about three different types of process. What is 1, 2, 2? Anyone please tell me, what is 1, 2, 2? I want the answer. You observe the proposition.
Sir, expansion process.
Expansion process, right? No, very good. Expansion process, right? So one, yes, two, sir. Two. Let us assume. Mm-hmm. Let us assume we have P line here. This is pressure. Sorry, this is volume. This volume. I have pressure. Let us. This is my diagram. PV diagram. Now, which process will give more amount of work during expansion process? I have adiabatic process. I have polytropic process. And I have isothermal. My volume line is here. I mean. This is volume, this is pressure, right? So this process, three different types of processes here. This is what PV power. Gamma is equals to constant. This is PV power, N is equals to constant. This is PV is equals to constant, right? So state 1 to 2, all these three processes are expansion process, as you said. Because from 1 to 2, 1 to 2, what happens to volume? 1 to 2, volume is increasing, pressure is decreasing. Therefore, these processes are called expansion process. Now tell me, which process will give more amount of work? Because during expansion process, work is extracted from the system. Work is extracted from the system because it is a positive work. During expansion system, W is equals to positive because work is extracted from the system. We, if the system follows, which process will get more work? Please tell me. And one more hint I will give. The area under PV diagram. The area under PV diagram gives work done. That you know. The area under PV diagram gives work done. Right. Now tell me. Suppose if the system follows adiabatic process, what is the area bounded by the curve? This one. This is the area bounded by the curve. And suppose if the system follows polytropic process, the area bounded by the curve is, let us say, there is no change in the point 2, only point 1 is increased. Now, this is the total area available for the polytropic process. And if the system follows isothermal process, there is no change in the point 2, point 1 is again raised. Now, where you are getting more area, which color shows more area?
Orange.
Orange, right? More area shows?
Orange.
It is nothing but iso? Isothermal.
Isothermal.
Isothermal means, if the expansion follows isothermal, then the work done is maximum.
Oh, okay, sir.
Right? If the expansion follows, if the system follows isothermal process, we can extract more amount of work. Suppose if,
yes,
the, if the system follows adiabatic, work done is less as compared to the isothermal process. Clear? By seeing this figure, you can say.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Sure.
Yeah, I think it's 11:10. We will stop today.
Okay, sir.
Okay,
bye, sir. Sir, you will send this PDF, sir.